87% of Australians over the age of 50 use at least one medicine each day. 40% of those use five or more medicines. We know that medicines have a really important role in improving the health of Australians. They prevent disease or treat symptoms of problems that we have right now. But getting the right information is a critical ingredient to using those medicines safely and effectively. There's a number of common myths about medicines that people often tell me, but when you break them down, many of them aren't true. I'm interested in challenging those myths so that people have the right information so that they can use their medicines safely and effectively. Many medicines are available in different brands. Each of those alternative brands have the same active ingredient, and they've been tested to make sure that they achieve the same concentration of that medicine in your blood. That's what we know is associated with the benefit that a medicine provides and even some of the harmful effects. Those alternative brands may have some things that are different though. They could have different inactive ingredients, different packaging and labelling, and the shape and colour of the tablet or the capsule could be quite different. But given that these medicines are carefully tested to make sure they meet the same standards for quality, safety, and efficacy, people should be confident that they'll do the same thing. The marketing claims for a number of pain-relieving medicines suggest that they're able to target particular parts of your body. The reality is quite different. When you take a medicine orally, it goes into your bloodstream and to all parts of your body. It can't target a particular type of pain. The risk is that if you believe that a medicine can specifically target one part of your body, you might be taking a medicine for your headache and your back pain and get double the dose that you really need. So remember, if you have pain, talk to your pharmacist or doctor about which of the pain-relieving medicines is most suitable for you. One in three Australians over the age of 50 regularly take a medicine to lower their cholesterol and reduce their risk of heart disease. The statin medicines are the most commonly prescribed. These medicines provide enormous benefit in reducing the burden of heart disease in an individual and also in the community. But many people don't realise that the benefits of using a statin to lower their cholesterol also require them to modify their lifestyle. And by that I mean increasing the amount of exercise they do and modifying their diet to eat less fat. These things as a package reduce your risk of heart disease. And if you only take the tablet, then you won't receive the same benefit. Combining alcohol with prescription medicines always should be done carefully. There's a number of medicines where alcohol should not be used. This includes a number of sedatives, some antihistamines, and also many of the medicines used to treat mental health problems. But the one that I've found most interesting over the years is people to say, "I'm on an antibiotic, I can't drink alcohol." There's only one class of antibiotics where there's a potential interaction with alcohol, and even the controlled studies there really couldn't show a real problem. So the reality is that alcohol and antibiotics don't interact. What does interact is alcohol and you. If you're on antibiotics and you're unwell, then alcohol will affect you more. So it's really important to use alcohol carefully in that setting and avoid any problems. So we're working towards the goal of personalised medicine. That's the right medicine for the right person with the right information that they can understand and use to get the best out of that medicine. So there may be a number of myths about the medicines that you're taking. Ask your pharmacist or doctor to explain the facts to you.